Hello and thanks for watching Proactive New York. I'm joined by James Sapirstein. He's Chairman, President and CEO of First Wave BioPharma. James, very good to meet you.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
It's a pleasure, James. So for those viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us more about First Wave BioPharma?
Absolutely. So we're a gastroenterology clinical development company. We have a couple of assets. So with those assets, we have multiple shots on goal. Our primary asset is adrulipase, which is an enzyme replacement therapy that we're studying for cystic fibrosis patients. And the other asset is niclosamide, where we're studying it right now for ulcerative proctitis and then later ulcerative colitis. And we have several indications associated with niclosamide.
So what's the development strategy for your pipeline, James?
So the company started back in 2014 and really with adrulipase. It used to be called MS-1819. Some of our viewers might be familiar with that term. So adrulipase is the generic name. We basically are studying it in cystic fibrosis, although we've done a proof of concept study in acute pancreatitis. We've achieved positive proof of concept both in cystic fibrosis as a replacement therapy for these patients who are not able to absorb nutrients. We've gone through four phase two studies, and right now, for the last 18 months, we've been working on a new formulation. What we discovered in those mixed results that we had was that the drug or the enzyme just wasn't absorbed correctly. So we feel we've got a strong formulation. We're finishing that up right now, and we'll be back in the clinic hopefully before the end of the year to do a bridging study that'll bridge us into phase three.
So and from phase three, you then head towards commercialization. Is that right?
That's correct. And the drug is really for cystic fibrosis is an orphan disease. It's a very popular disease and it's a big market. These folks are on several medications every single day, but there aren't, you know, it's still an orphan disease. So we expect that the FDA would say to us, we only need one trial. The FDA does not like doing a lot of clinical trials on folks that do not have a lot of options. And we can get into the particulars of the drug, but it's going to really make for an unmet need that's resolved in these patients. So we've gotten good cooperation at the agency as well.
I mean, take us through the market for gastrointestinal therapies, such as the two you've mentioned.
So with adrulipase, the big market leaders are AbbVie. AbbVie has a product called Creon. They sell about $1.25 billion a year. The second product is called Zempep. And Zempep is manufactured now by Nestle. It used to be an Allergan product. That's about a little over $250,000 a year. But all told, the market is about $2 billion worldwide. And basically what it is for these people who can't absorb nutrients. These are enzymes. Creon is made from pig pancreases, quite frankly, crushed up pig pancreases. We have a humanized version. We grow it in vats. We make ours from yeast cells and enzymes that are produced from those cells as we grow them in vats. So I equate it to insulin's on everybody's mind, but human insulin, when it first came out, it replaced porcine-derived insulin that had been around for about 85 years. And we see this as a need as well. Patients take anywhere from 25 to 40 capsules a day of Creon and some of these other competitors. We believe we can get away with about 5 to 8 capsules per day of our enzymes. So it's a significant upgrade for these patients.
I mean, would you put that down as one of your main competitive advantages then in that market, James?
Oh, absolutely. And also we've been able to bring our cost of goods way, way down. So we're going to be price competitive. We're going to be compliance competitive. And also, you know, drugs that come from animals, quite frankly, they cause antigenicity issues and resistance problems over the course of time. We don't expect that we'll have that problem.
James, what sorts of milestones should investors be looking out for then as you progress those two drugs?
Well, I didn't talk too much about niclosamide, so let me talk about that too. Niclosamide, we've got a study that's reading out in ulcerative proctitis. We have an open IND for a checkpoint inhibitor colitis. And so the investors should be looking out for announcements on those things. As far as adrulipase goes, they should be looking out specifically for an announcement on our manufacturing formulation. Once we choose the one we're going with, we'll make an announcement. And then when we're back in the clinic, and the clinical trial is going to be fairly small, we hope to have data by the end of the second quarter next year. So over the next year or so, we've got about 4 or 5 announcements.
James, I hope you'll keep us posted on any developments with both of those drugs, but thank you very much for the introduction today.
Thank you very much. Thanks for your time.
James Sapirstein is the chairman, president, and the CEO of First Wave BioPharma.